So good morning again. So we have previously discussed the Coulomb's law and electric field intensity, the theory. Now we are going to discuss the numerical based on it. So here we will start. Now this is what a brief review of Coulomb's law. Anyone can just explain me rule number 67. Roll number 67, A67. Sonia.
Yes, sir.
Just explain me the Coulomb's law. We discussed previously.
So I don't remember, sir.
It is displayed on the screen, my dear. You can take a reference. You just read that statement.
The force between two very small objects separated in vacuum or a free space by a distance which is large as compared to their size is proportional to charge on each and inversely proportional to distance between them.
What it mean? Here there are two charges are mentioned. The formula, the force, that is Q1, Q2 are the two charges. They are separated by the distance. So the force is directly proportional to the multiplication charges of two charges and inversely proportional to the distance square. Okay, and what is the K? That also we discussed. K is something different. That is a constant. So that we discuss K equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0. Okay, epsilon 0 is what? It is permittivity of free space if the charges are in the free space. And what is epsilon 0 value? It is 8.854
into 10 to the power minus 12.
Or you can have in terms of pi, 1 upon 36 pi into 10 to the power minus 9 farad per meter. I'll recommend to use the second one to have the easier calculation in the numerical. Okay. So this is epsilon 0 value. All of you, please be ready with your notebook because we are going for the numericals. So simultaneously, you can solve these numericals in your notebook to have a practice. So I'll ask the answer. Okay. So this is what the constant. Epsilon is equals to epsilon 0 into epsilon r. Epsilon r is the relative permittivity. Okay. Now we will have this epsilon 0 is permittivity of free space. So this is what the basic. So based by using this, already we did that. F2 is what? F2 is the force acting on Q2 by Q1. So the F2 equals to Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. This is what the formula. But as this is force is the vector, so here is the vector. This is called the unit vector. Unit vector between charge 1 and 2. So starting from charge 1 and ending at charge 2. So it is A12. Okay. And A12 is equals to what? Is equals to vector joining these two points Q1 and Q2. Okay. So that is what denoted as R, vector R upon magnitude of R. So this is what the basic definition that you people are previously aware. Now, we will go for this simple problem. All of you please ready with your pen and notebook and calculator also. So what is the problem here? A charge Q1 is given as 30 millicoulomb at point M. So M is the one point where 1, 2, 3 is the point. Okay, so it is a Cartesian coordinate system and a charge Q2. Another charge is here. So charge may be positive or negative. So this is the negative charge. So Q2 is negative charge. That is 0.1 millicoulomb at N. N is the point where Q2 is located. That is 205 in a vacuum. So vacuum or free space. So you have to use the epsilon 0. Find force exerted on Q2 by Q1. So we are interested force on Q2 by Q1. So this is simple numerical. Two charges are given. The values of the charges are given. Where they are located, that is also given. So from that, what we have to do? First, we have to draw diagram. So I'll just simply draw a diagram. What is one point and another point? This is one point and this is another point. So here, this is what the charge Q1 and this is what the charge Q2. The Q1 is at 123 and Q2 is at 205. As the other part, I have not drawn it in the Cartesian coordinate system, simply I have drawn. You can draw it in a Cartesian coordinate system to have a practice and the understanding. In other problem, I'll try to draw it. So what we have to do, we have to find it out the vector R. R what? This is what force exerted on Q2. So a direction is most important. We have asked the force exerted on Q2. So the direction of force is F2. So this F2 we have to. So we are interested in the R12 from this point 1 to point 2, R12. How we will do that? Simply this X, Y, Z, and this is in Cartesian coordinate system. So X here is 2, here is 1. So end point, where the vector is ending, this is the end point. So end point minus start point. So 2 minus 1, simple your distance formula you can say. 2 minus 1, so here 2 minus 1. And this vector coordinate is AX. So this is AX is the unit vector along the x-axis. Same thing here, this is y coordinate. This is what is y coordinate for here, for the endpoint, that is 0, 0 minus 2. And what is the coordinate? AY. So 0 minus 2, because it is along the y-axis, AY. Plus, so everything is added. Then 5 minus 3, this is what the z-coordinate. 5 minus 3 AZ. So this way, what you got? This way you got the a vector R12. So vector R12 is 2 minus 1 is 1 AX, 0 minus 2 minus 2 AY, 5 minus 3 2 AZ. This is what the vector R12. Now unit vector. How we will find it out the unit vector? Simple. If you are aware how to find it out, sorry, for finding out the unit vector, you have to find it out the magnitude of this vector R12. So what will be the magnitude? How can we find it out? Simply, this is what the magnitude of x-axis, magnitude of y-axis, magnitude of z-axis. So what you can do, simply, you can do here that the one under root of one square plus two square plus three square. One square is one, two square is four, two square is four. So one plus four plus four. So it becomes under root of nine. So under root of nine equals to three. So you can write it down in your notebook. Okay. So under root of nine is whatever three. Is it clear? Okay. So your magnitude is 3. Now what we want a unit vector joining again the same point. So A12. So what is the formula? The vector divided by unit vector. So vector is here. So we have AX, AY, AZ. Multiplication is there. So R12 divided by 3. So this is what your unit vector. So your unit vector calculation must be correct. Here you require a Cartesian coordinate system concept. Here you require concept of vector. Once this is correct, then the other things are only the calculation. What is your formula? Q1 Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square AR. AR means the vector joining from 1 to 2. So this is what the unit vector A12. So Q1 value is given, Q2 value is given. 4 pi is there, epsilon, instead of epsilon, what it is in a vacuum or free space. So this you can put epsilon 0, R square is given. So R is what? Magnitude. So this R is given here, 3, magnitude is 3. So R square is 3 square. And unit vector, this unit vector is also calculated here. Now, if you will solve this, All of you just verify putting the value in this formula. You will get finally this one, minus 1000 AX, because here is the value. So why we got minus? Here AX is plus, because one charge Q2 is negative. So you will get the sign change. So minus 1000 AX plus 2000 AY minus 2000 AZ. And what is the force? Don't forget to mention the unit. Unit is Newton. So F2 is this. So this is what the simple calculation for finding out the force. So this is the simplest formula, what you can say, numerical. Is there any doubt in this? Because this type of calculation will be there in each and every problem, next two chapters, these calculations are there. So you have to understand this, because afterwards I may not able to explain it in detail this way. So is there any confusion in this or any doubt? You can ask. Anyone?
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you explain that A1 to unit vector once again, sir, from there? Is 1 upon 3 bracket mein AX minus 2AY.
Okay, I'll explain the entire thing again so that you can understand it in a very clear way.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so what? Okay, so I'll go for this numerical. What is the problem given? Two charges are there. Their values are given, and where they are located, it is given. One charge is as 1, 2, 3, another charge is 2, 0, 5. Okay, one charge is 1, 2, 3, another charge is 2, 0, 5. So I have put the charges. So Q1 is at 1, 2, 3, and Q2 is at 2, 0, 5. Simultaneously, you will do it on the paper, so you will understand very easily. Now, what is required? As we discuss, we require a unit vector. So how to calculate the unit vector for joining this? So unit vector calculation, I'll explain, because you will require this in each and every numerical. Now unit vector joining Q1, Q2, direction is important. Direction is this. So this is what Q2 is the end point and Q1 is the start point. So how to get the vector? That is the end point minus start point. And this is a Cartesian coordinate system. So X, Y, Z are the axis. So unit vector of respective axis are AX, AY, and AZ for the Cartesian coordinate system. For the other coordinate system, they are different. Now, what is the endpoint here? 2 minus 1. Why endpoint? Because we want force on Q2 by Q1. So 2 minus 1, AX. Then second, Y axis, 0 minus 2. Okay, so endpoint. Third, Z axis, 5 minus 3. So 5 minus 3, AZ. So this is what the simple thing. End point minus start point. AX, AY, AZ. We know the noting of this point, AX, AY, AZ. This way. So we got this. So do the simple subtraction for this. 2 minus 1, 1 AX. 0 minus 2, minus 2 AY. 5 minus 3, 2 AZ. So we got the... This is the vector. Now we are interested in the magnitude. So magnitude of the vector is the simple formula. Whatever the x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis coordinate, you have to take a under root and square. Okay. So under root of, you just write it down the formula. Under root of x, ax square. What is the multiplier? 1. So 1 square. Then plus 2 square, minus 2 square, so it becomes plus. So 2 square, then again 2 square. So 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square. So 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 2 square is 4. So 1 plus 4 plus 4. So it becomes 9 and it is in under root. So under root means under root of 9 is 3. So you got this as the 3. Up till now, is it okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we will go for finding out the unit vector. Now unit vector is what? A12. Now this is what? This is a vector. Now we are going to find it out, the unit vector. Formula is vector, whatever the vector divided by the magnitude. So this is what the vector divided by magnitude is 3, 1 by 3 into this. Simple. Unit vector, do you understand?
Yes, sir. And then, sir, in this bracket one, we have to do the same thing once again, or what? Root, taking root of square. 1 by 3, the bracket one. Unit vector.
For unit vector, simply unit vector is the magnitude, whatever the vector divided by magnitude.
Okay,
formula for the unit vector is vector. So what is vector? R12 divided by the magnitude. Okay, so this is
okay.
No need to take root again. So
okay,
vector,
sir.
You have calculated the vector. So this is the vector divided by magnitude. Is it okay? So unit vector calculation procedure is same everywhere, and we require in each and every problem. If there is any problem, you can ask again.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so I will go further. Now this is simply the formula. Now unit vector is required to put in this formula. That's why we have calculated the unit vector. So this is what the unit vector is. So the unit vector is this much. We know Q1 is known, Q2 is known, 4 pi we know, epsilon here, epsilon equals to epsilon 0. Why? Because it is told that it is in a vacuum. Okay, vacuum or free space, then you have to use a epsilon 0. And R square is what? Here you have to take a magnitude. What is the R? Here is the R magnitude. That is 3. So you have to put the 3 square. So put this value and put this multiplier. That is the unit vector. You just do this calculation on your notebook. That's why I told that you should have a notebook. And simultaneously you can do it so that you will get the understanding. So you will get this final answer. Have you got this final answer? Those they got the final answer, 1000 minus 1000 AX plus 2000 AY minus 2000 AZ. Please reply.
Yes, sir, got. Sir, I got the answer.
Okay, thank you very much. So everyone has to do this. If you will not do this, then it is very difficult. Okay, another also, I got a response in the chat. The other people also, they got the answer. So if you will do it on by your own, then and then you can understand. Otherwise, next time you will forget everything. Okay, now we will go to the next numerical. So this is a very simplest form. Now in the next numerical, I will not explain the calculation of the unit vector and the other. Okay. Now the next problem. What is given in the next problem? Point charge is given, Q1. What is that? 300 microcoulomb located at point 1, minus 1, minus 3. Okay. So these points are given. And what? Experience a force. What is that force? That is the F1. Now force is given. The Q1 is experiencing a force F1. That is 8AX minus 8AY plus 4AZ Newton due to a point charge Q2 at what point? 3 minus 3, 2. Determine Q2. Now it is in a reverse way. First problem was the simple problem. Now it is the reverse problem. Force is given. But force is exerting on F1. Force is exerting on Q1 by the Q2. And magnitude of Q2 is unknown. Location of both the charges are given. So this is what simple way what we can do it. Now here we do a diagram. Now Q1 is at 1 minus 1 minus 3. Q2 is 3 minus 3 minus 2. Locations are given. arrow is the important. We are interested to find it out. F1, that is the force exerting on Q1. In the previous problem, it was opposite. Now, in this problem, it is we are interested to find it out. F1, that is force exerted on Q1 by Q2. Okay. Now, we will put up the formula. Now, this is what the diagram I have taken here for your reference. Force exerted on this Q1 by Q2. Now, what? Again, we have to do the same thing. What? We have to find it out the vector R21. So, R21, you can find it out. Now, end point is this. So, that is 1 minus 3 minus 2ax and then minus 1 minus minus 3. So, that is 2a1 minus 3 minus minus 2. Just remember, minus 3 minus minus 2. You have to take a difference. So, it is minus 3 plus 2. So, it is minus az. Okay, so this one is the vector you got. Understood? Now you find it out the unit vector. Unit vector is vector divided by its magnitude. So what is magnitude? Magnitude is under root of 2 square, 2 square, 1 square. 2 square is 4 plus 4, 8. 1 square is 1. So 2, 4 plus 4 plus 1. How much? 9. Under root of 9 is 3. Okay, so here is 3. So this is what your you can say a unit vector. So unit vector calculation is done. Okay, and this is what you can say the if you have calculated the vector and unit vector, then you can go for the calculation of force. So what is force? Now here this vector, you just remember the unit vector is 2, 1. If 2 is the starting 2 is the starting point, 1 is the end point. The force exerted on 1 by 2. So 2, 1. Start and end point. The start point is 2, end point is 1. So unit vector. Formula is same. Q1, Q2 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square. So R is 2, 1. So magnitude is 3. Q1 is known. Q2 is unknown. 4 pi is known. Free space, so epsilon 0. So F1 is given, that F1 is this 8ax minus 8ay plus 4az. This is given. Now Q1 is given. Q1 is 300 microcoulomb. So 300 into 10 to the power minus 6. Always remember that the conversion formula, microcoulomb, so 300 into 10 to the power minus 6. Q2, Q2 is unknown because that we have to find it out. Upon 4 pi epsilon 0, I put the value. So that is 1 upon 36 pi into 10 to the power minus 9. This is 4. And what is R? Magnitude is given here. Magnitude is 3. So 3 square. So this is 4. And what is this? This is the unit vector. Unit vector is minus 2ax plus 2ay minus az upon 3. So this is given. Now you have to find it out Q. You have to, vector is there on the both sides. So you have to normalize. You have to cancel. How can be done? So this is 2ax, 2ay and 1az. So if I will do here, if I will put 4 outside, so whether I will get, sorry, minus 4 outside from this, minus 4 outside. So what I'll get? I'll get the same. Minus 2ax plus 2ay and minus az. So take down the 4 outside. Then the vector on both the side can be cancelled. And then Q2, you can do the calculation. All of you just do this and give me the value of Q2. I'll just wait for a while. Quickly. Okay, so this is what the answer. Answer is what? Minus 40 microcoulomb. Okay, unit is important. You always write a unit. Okay. So minus 40, minus is there. So as the negative sign is here. So this way we got the answer. So these are the simple calculation. If you will do the focus calculation, you will get the answer very correctly. Okay. Now, is there any doubt? I don't think so. We are going very smoothly and very slowly, so that if you will understand, then we can increase our speed afterwards for the other problem, because procedure is same, only you have to understand how it can be done. Now, third problem is find the force on a 100 microcoulomb charge at 0.03 meter if four like charges of 20 microcoulomb are located on the x and y axis at +4 and -4 meter. Now, this problem is the problem combined of four different problems. How? So first, you just understand what is given. Find the force on a 100 microcoulomb charge where it is located, 0.03. Means on which axis this charge is located? Anyone quickly?
Z axis.
Correct.
Z.
Yes, it is at the Z axis, Z equals to 3 meter. If four like charges, means four different charges, like charges, same charges, of how much is the magnitude? 20 microcoulomb. Unit is also given, 20 microcoulomb, are located on XY, X axis and Y axis at +4 and -4 meter. Means where they are at the X axis, both the side, positive X axis, minus negative X axis, Y axis, positive X axis, negative X axis, at what distance? 4 meter. What will be the diagram? Can anyone imagine the diagram? I'll just share the diagram. Is it the correct diagram? Now what? I'll just name this as the Q1 for the understanding and solving. This is Q1 on the y-axis, Q2 again on the y-axis, Q3 on the positive x-axis, and Q4 on the negative x-axis. And what this Q5 is, what this is, what the charge given, that is 0.03. That is on the Z axis. Is this diagram clear? If this is clear, then we can go very quickly. Is there any doubt in this diagram? I don't think so. It is very simple. It is very simple. Now, if this diagram is clear, now what you have to do, though they can do the first calculation for them, what we have to find it out, the force acting by Q1 on Q5. Okay, so this force, you Q1, Q5, find it out. Then Q2, Q5, find it out that force. Q3, Q5, find it out that force. Q4, Q5, find it out that force. All the four forces, you find it out. And then at the last, what? You just add. That's it. So that is what the all four charges, whatever the force exerted on Q5. So simply, we have to repeat the very first problem for the fourth time. Nothing else is it. Now, I'll just, for the understanding, I'll just go on the next slide and I'll put the this point. So what is Q5 is here, 0.03, and Q1 is at 0.40. 0.40 means it is on which axis? Intentionally, I have not kept the diagram. 0.40, which axis?
Sir, positive y.
Y.
Yes, correct. Positive y axis. Correct. Very correct. So we will take this first, Q1 first. Okay. Now you just find it out the vector. Again, the procedure is same. Find it out the vector from Q1 to Q5. Start point is Q1. End point is Q5. So vector calculation, 0 minus 0. So 0 ax. लिखने का जरूरत नहीं, 0 -4 ay, so -4 ay, 3 -0, so 3 az, so what is the vector? 1 5 always number the vector 1, 5, starting from 1, ending at 5. Remember this, 1, 5 means starting from 1, ending at 5. So end point minus start point. Okay, if you require, you can write it down somewhere. So otherwise, sometimes it may get somewhat confusing. 1, 5 means start point is 1, end point is 5 for this vector. Calculating the vector is end point minus start point. End point is this one minus start point. So you got the vector. Unit vector is vector divided by unit vector. How unit vector you can calculate? The magnitude of whatever this, square of this and under root of this. So 4 square and 3 square. 4 square 16 plus 3 square is how much? 9. So 16 plus 9, how much? 16 plus 9, quickly.
25.
Simple.
Under root 25,
5. Is 5, correct. So it is 5. So unit vector is minus 4ay plus 3az upon 5. So this is that much simple. So this is unit vector you got. Now what force on Q5 due to Q1 is, how formula is there, F15, Q1, Q5. Q1, Q5 upon 4 pi epsilon 0. Epsilon 0 is what? Because if it is not given in the problem, the medium, so you can consider by default medium as the air or the free space or the vacuum. So you can by default consider the epsilon 0. If it is mentioned the specific medium, then epsilon r value is mentioned in the problem. Here it is not mentioned. So consider epsilon 0. And this is what vector, magnitude of the vector R15. Magnitude is 5. And this is what the unit vector. So give me the quickly the answer. Whether this is the correct answer? You can just multiply this 0.144 into the other. So I kept intentionally this so that at the last I will get the very easy calculation. Or you can multiply, nothing is a problem. Have you got this answer? So here, vectors, now for the Q2, we are saying Q2 to Q5. So Q2 to Q5, we are saying, so find it out the vector. So vector R25 is the same way as we have done previously. So only sign change will be there because here it was plus 4, here it is minus 4. So 4ay plus 3az is the vector. Unit vector is this, 4ay plus 3az. So divided by 5 is the magnitude. That how magnitude is calculated, 4 square plus 3 square under root of this addition. So it becomes 5. Now force exerting on Q5 due to Q2 is, formula is same, calculations will be same, only vector will get changed. So that's why I have put this vector in the bracket. So this factor 0.144 will remain same. Only you have to take care of this, whether it is plus or minus. So anybody just confirm it, whether you got this answer, whether this is the correct answer, so that I can go further.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we'll go further. Now, third chart. Vector joining Q3 to Q5. Same thing is repeated. Only now sign will get changed. Now Q3. Now previously, what we got? Y. Now here, x-axis will be there, x and z. Because x previously only y and z factor were there in the vector. Now here, x and z will be there. So minus 4ax, because the end point is this, start point is this. So this is 4. So 0 minus 4 is minus 4ax. And then 3 minus 0, that is plus 3az. This is the vector. Unit vector. Magnitude will be same because 3 and 4 square, addition of 3 square plus 4 square and under root of that. So that will be 5. So 16 plus 9, under root of 16 plus 9 is 25, 25 under root is 5. So unit vector is vector divided by magnitude. And then force 3, 5, force exerting on 5 by 3. So Q3, Q5 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square ar. So r square, r is magnitude is 5 and unit vector is you have calculated. Again the same. So instead of previously y, here it will be 4 minus 4ax. The rest of the magnitude will be remain same. Is it, have you got this? Anybody got the answer? Pranay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I'll go for the last charge because same thing we are repeating. Now the last charge. Okay. This type of problem will come in the exam. Now vector joining Q4 and Q5. So Q4 is here, Q5 is here. Same thing. Now here instead of minus 4x, it will be plus 4x because the point is on the x-axis. One point is on x-axis, one is on z-axis. Y is 0 here. So y will not come. So simply what you can say 4x because here x coordinate is 4. So 4x plus 3az. Okay. Sorry, here the minus 4. Minus 4, so it becomes 0 minus minus 4, so plus 4ax and 3 minus 0. So it is 3az. So 4ax plus 3az, magnitude remains same, 5. Formula is remains same. Q4, Q5 upon 4 pi epsilon 0, r square and to ar. So it will remain same. 1.44, 0.144 factor is there and only vector will get changed. Okay. Now, all the four forces you got. Now, what to do? Now, at the last, you just add this. So, force exerted on Q5 due to Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 is simply the addition. Q5 is force by 1 on 5, force on 2 on 5, force by 3 on 5, force by 4 on 5. So, this is what the addition. So, this is what force F15. F15 is 0.144 into this factor minus AY plus 3AZ. And then we have the next, that is 0.144 into 4AY plus 3AZ. Then next 0.144 minus 4AX plus 3AZ and plus 0.144.4AX plus 3AZ. Now simply you can do the calculation. 4AY minus 4AY plus 4AY. Addition, it will be 0. Then minus 4AX plus 4AX. Addition, it will be 0. So 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3AZ. So 12AZ into this multiplication. Simply do this multiplication. You will get this 1.728 AZ Newton. Is it correct? Anyone can just verify this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is what the answer you people got. This is a simple, but you have to be very cautious while doing plus minus and all this. So the calculations are very simple, but it require a concentration and you should be cautious. So these are the simple example. Okay. So this is what the this type of example you can do. Now, electric field intensity. We will take one problem on electric field intensity. Okay. Now, what is electric field intensity? We know. Now, force, this definition that in the Coulomb's law, we replace Q2 by Qt that we discussed last time. Qt is the test charge moving around Q1. So there exists everywhere a force on Qt and then the Coulomb's law will be. What will be the Coulomb's law? Ft equals to Q1 Qt upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square A1t. After that, we did a simple modification. Force per unit charge is the electric field intensity. So electric field intensity is the force per unit test charge. The function Q1 and the function of Q1 and the direct line segment from Q1 to a position of the test charge. This describes a vector field and is called the electric field intensity. So simply you can say the force per unit test charge is nothing but the electric field intensity denoted by E. So E equals to Q. Instead of Q1, now you can say Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square. R square is the vector where you have to find it out the electric field intensity, AR, Newton per Coulomb. Newton per Coulomb, or we did the mapping Newton per Coulomb or volt per meter. Now generally volt per meter is used in the general application. Now we will go for this unit. This power, this calculation that we did last time, power equals to volt into ampere. Unit of power is watt, that is volt into ampere. So volt into ampere, ampere can be coulombs per second, and power can be written as joule per second. So this is what how the unit is there, that is I am saying. Okay, so joule per second, second get cancelled. Joule can be Newton meter, and here volt coulomb. So if you will rearrange it, so it will be Newton per coulomb equals to volt per meter. So both the unit are same. Generally we use the volt per meter unit for the electric field intensity. Now we will take this one problem and we'll stop. So find the electric field intensity at this point 0.34 meter due to a point charge 0.5 microcoulomb placed at the origin. So a point is placed at origin and you have to find it out the electric field intensity at this point. So simple calculation. It is same as the previous problem. So draw a diagram, simple diagram. So this is what your origin. This is what point 0.34. X-axis is missing. So 3 and 4, it is in YZ plane. And this is what your R. So for how we can do this? The vector joining charge Q at the origin. So charge Q is at the origin. And the point is 0.34. So this is vector starting from here to here, because we are intend to find it out the electric field intensity at this particular point. Okay. So what is 0 minus 0, 0 AX, no need to write. 3 minus 0, 3 AY, 4 minus 0, 4 AZ. Vector is calculated, unit vector. 3 square, 9, 4 square, 16. 9 plus 16, 25, under root of 25 is 5. Okay. So, unit vector, the magnitude is calculated. Unit vector is vector divided by unit vector. This calculation is done. This is unit vector. Electric field intensity is Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 R square AR. So, AR is this unit vector. So, AR is this unit vector. Q, it is given 4 pi. You know, epsilon 0 value is given, R square is 5. Give me the answer quickly. So here, this is what the answer. Answer is 108 AY plus 144 AZ. Okay, this answer. How many of you got this answer quickly? Okay, I got a response in the chat. Okay. So you got the same answer. So